As a home brewer, the mashing and home brewing process is very much parallel to a commercial, just a smaller scale. I have a system that I can do 10 gallon batches of beer, where the large tanks behind me, you're looking at 700-800 gallons. The process is the same, the time is about the same. You'll require 30 to 60 minutes for converting your mash, your grains, and your water into your wort. Another hour in boiling and chilling, and yeast, adding your yeast to your finished product. As a home brewer, I don't have a production schedule. I am very much more relaxed about letting the yeast do its job. I could leave a fermenter with beer in it for 2, 3, possibly 4 weeks if I am not able to take it to the next step. The process allows me a lot more relaxation. It's not a job. I'm not producing it for anybody but myself. So I let things take a little bit more natural course. I will either bottle or keg my beers. And I typically will re-ferment in that bottle or keg to get my carbonation. And then that process is another couple weeks of natural fermenting at room temperature. Whatever sugar I add to the keg or bottle is converted by the yeast that's still suspended in there. You know, the beer is a living thing. As much as you try to filter it out, there'll still be some residual yeast there. And if yeast is there, it'll want to live and convert sugars into alcohol and carbon dioxide. So my beers will condition themselves in their bottle or the keg, and I let them sit for another 2 weeks. That gives the beer a chance to settle and then refrigerate it. Refrigeration is its own natural clarifier. That's why lagers and chilled beers are taken down to real low temperatures, because the whatever suspended particulates in the beer will settle faster in a cold liquid. So I'll let my beer sit in cold condition for a couple weeks, and either all of the yeast and sediment will filter down to the bottom of a bottle or down to the bottom of the keg. And after the first couple pulls from my tap system, those are all fed from the bottom. So all of the yeast and particulates and whatever has settled out of the beer after the first 2 or 3 pulls will clarify. So out of a 5-gallon keg of beer, I'll pull 3 or 4 pints off of it. And after that, my beers are perfectly clear and ready to serve.